Hey YouTube, welcome back to News in 2 Minutes, bringing you the news that you need to know every day. Let's begin. The U.S. Chemical Safety Board, a federal agency charged with investigating industrial chemical accidents, has been denied access to employees and witnesses in the April 17th blast at a Texas fertilizer plant that shook houses miles away and left a crater nearly 100 feet wide at the site. In a span of 24 hours, the U.S. Senate panel has passed the largest immigration policy change to hit the U.S. in a generation and has approved the U.S.'s weaponization of Syria's rebel army, the FSA. The Bank of Japan affirmed its stimulus program today, even as policies are seen as backfiring in the housing market, where mortgage rates are continuing to rise amid the fifth month of deflationary figures in the country. The U.S. stock market closed at record highs on Tuesday as Ben Bernanke is expected to announce the continuation of America's stimulus program before Congress today, proving the deepening disconnect between digital monetary policy and economic reality. A Tunisian man has succumbed to the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, becoming the first African fatality from the virus that currently holds a near 50% mortality rate in confirmed cases. In ongoing coverage, the World Health Organization states that the Tunisian case won't change their assessment of the virus, but it does prove that it is still spreading. Riots in Sweden have continued for their second day as hundreds gathered to protest the alleged police brutality and wrongful shooting of a 69-year-old man. The U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry met with senior diplomats from 11 countries today in Jordan as part of a joint U.S. and Russian plan to end Syria's civil war. Ironically, this is happening on the same day that the U.S. Senate panel approved arming the rebels. U.N. officials are expressing concern as the number of Syrian refugees fleeing to Jordan has dropped from over 2,000 per day to less than 20. Officials believe that something is stopping refugees from accessing the borders from within Syria. In a study by the British Medical Journal, scientists examined the records of nearly 10 million people to conclude that there is a confirmed cancer risk following CT scans in childhood, waylaying the misspoken claim that a little radiation is good for you. An IRS official is reportedly claiming her Fifth Amendment rights to silence when summoned by Congress on Tuesday. Video arose of what is allegedly Pope Francis performing an exorcism on a Mexican man. A hidden trip from the Japanese Prime Minister's advisor to North Korea became public, sparking rumors in Asia. And voters in Portland, Oregon have again rejected the fluoridation of their water supply, making it the largest city in the United States to not have the chemical added to its water. And that's it for today's News in 2 Minutes. Check back tomorrow for more news that the aware need the most. This week's News in 2 Minutes is brought to you by SQMetals.com, where you'll find great deals on gold, silver, platinum, and coins from reliable people who care. Visit SQMetals.com today.